In this video, I'm going to show you the best features you're not using in the Microsoft applications you work with on a daily basis. Featuring Excel, Teams, PowerPoint, Outlook, and Word. Tip number one, probably the best time-saving tip in Excel. Let me show you. Here I have a list of fake email addresses, and I want to create a list of just the names. To make this extra challenging, I want them to be listed by surname, then first name. I start by entering the first one in the format I want. I press Enter, then press Control E, and my work here is done. Next! Tip number two. Did you know you can quickly quote a previous message when you reply in chat in Microsoft Teams? This helps to bring a bit of context to your replies. You can do this on the mobile and desktop app. Let me show you. In the mobile app, swipe left to right on the message to reply. In the desktop or web versions, hover the mouse over the message, click here, and then click reply. For this next tip, we're going to look at how to share PowerPoint correctly. So let's open up our share tray. Screen allows me to share my whole desktop, so the attendees will be able to see anything that's on my screen. The other option here is window. So this is if I want to share one application only. If you're looking to share PowerPoint only, then look for PowerPoint Live. If it's none of these presentations, then either open up your PowerPoint from OneDrive or from your local computer. In this example, my presentation is saved in OneDrive. Now, the great thing about PowerPoint Live is that I can see my notes, and I can also see my slide deck. Another advantage of using PowerPoint Live is that attendees can click through your slides at their own pace. So if it's a long presentation, this can be really helpful. If the attendees think you're going too fast or too slow, they can go backwards or move forwards through your slide set. Attendees can click here, and this will take them back to whatever the presenter has on their screen. If you don't want your attendees to click through your slides, then simply click here. Tip number four. Did you know when sending a meeting invite to multiple people, you can hide their emails from the recipients? This is useful when you need to keep their details private. You can do this by logging into Outlook for the web, which you can access through office.com. Set up a new event, and here you have the option to hide the attendance list. Be warned, it won't hide their emails when they join a Teams meeting. Tip number five is one of my favorite new features that came out in 2021. It's the ability to convert a Word document like this into a PowerPoint presentation. And you can do this in just a couple of clicks. Let me show you. First thing you need to do is open up your Word document in Word Online. For best results, use headings using the styles. Once you've set up your document, go to File, then Export, and you want to export to PowerPoint. Here you have a list of design themes to choose from. You can change the layout and images later if needed. Click the slide design that you want to use, and then click Export. PowerPoint will then work its magic. Click Open Presentation, and here you have your presentation created for you automatically. If you don't like this image, you can change it by right-clicking on the image and then going to Change Picture. Choose one of the available options. I'm going to go for Stock. Type in your search, and then select your image. If you want to change the layout of the slides, then use one of the suggested options here.
Tip number six.
Images in PowerPoint don't need to be boring. Let me show you. Here I have a map of the world. Rather than using this static map, I can smoothly zoom in to the different areas around the world using the best transition in PowerPoint. Let me show you. So I start by making a copy of this slide. If I right click here and then select duplicate, I next zoom out, so I've got lots of space. What you need to do next is resize and position this image so that it's focused on the country that you want to talk about next in your presentation. So in this example, I want to focus on the US. So I'll just click here and then resize the image by dragging these handles. And you want the main focal point to be in the center of the slide. And you can use this thumbnail as a guide. And I repeat this process for the other countries that I want to talk about. Once you've resized and positioned your slides, it's always a good idea to go back to the starting slide. So to do this, I'm going to make a copy of the first slide, and I'm going to paste it in here. I click down here to fit to screen. And the final step is to select these slides here. And you can do this by using the Shift key and then select here, and that will select those four slides. Now for the magic touch. I click Transitions, and then I've got Morph. Probably the best transition in PowerPoint. So let's test this now by starting the presentation. There's my first slide. And then when I click the next slide, it zooms smoothly over to the next country that I want to talk about in my presentation. Click again. And it's like I'm traveling around the world. If you found this video useful, please click like and subscribe and ring that bell so you don't miss future videos like this. And I will see you in this video here.